Expand the work library and start the simulation of the VHDL file by right-clicking on it and choosing Simulate. The left-hand side of the screen should now contain a Sim tab that displays the design units in your circuit and the supporting libraries. When a design unit is selected in the Sim tab, the corresponding signals are shown in the Objects window on the right-hand side of the screen. Signals that are preceded with a plus sign indicate a bus, which means a group of wires with a common function. For the first input signal that you want to add to the simulation, right-click on the signal name in the Objects window and select Create Wave. A waveform window will appear in the work area. A dialog window will open for the signal. Select a counter. Adjust the counter parameters. The input should now show up in the wave window. Repeat this for each of the input signals. If you're using a counter for each input, you'll want to make sure the time period for each one is twice the previous one. Now add the output signal to the wave window. Note that the output isn't showing any waveform yet. In the tool icons, find the window that contains the period of the signal, for example, 100 nanoseconds. Change the period to something long enough to show the whole simulation, for example, 1,000 nanoseconds. To the right of that window will be the Run All Simulation icon, which looks like a page with a double blue down arrow beside it. Click it to run the simulation. You should see the inputs that you entered and the outputs from your system on the waveform. The period of the run will correspond to the time in the period window. All of the signals should be green. If any signals are red, then one or more of the inputs were not specified.